Vasanta from Smart Tech Guide. Today I'm coming with a few tips for the photo management, photo sharing, and few other tips on the Google data. Let's start with the photo management. If you haven't used Google Photo, if you are on iPhone or Mac, and if you haven't used Google Photos, you can download Google Photos app, or you can visit on the photos.google.com, and there you can have free photo storage on the cloud for your lifetime, at this point at least. And that's with small tips. If you save your original quality, then it won't be free, and that will consume your Google Drive space. 15 GB is free out of box, but if you want to buy extra storage, then that's per month subscription. But if you want to save all of your photos for free without paying a penny, in that case, you may want to choose the high quality standard instead of full quality. I'm gonna show you in a minute. And with that, you can save all of your photo in Google Drive for free, and that's for a lifetime. At this point, they haven't made any constraints so far, so it's totally free, and it doesn't consume your Google Drive space. And some user get Drive space problem because they might have chosen full quality. Some user doesn't even use Google Photos, and they might be looking for the appropriate solution. If you are looking for appropriate solution, or you are using Google Photos but you couldn't manage your storage and sharing options, watch this. Let me go to my Android device. This is my Android device here, and I'm going to Google Photos app. By default, this is the Google Photo app, and you can download it on Apple Store if you are an iOS device, or if you are an Android device, it should be by default on your phone. Once you go to the Google Photo app, there will be a lot of setting. You have to be logged in with Google account first of all, and one thing you can go is go to setting and then choose backup and setting. Over there are few settings you can choose, whether you want to have high quality free unlimited storage, these options, or if you click on that, it will show you the another options, original quality, and that takes your Google Drive space. That means if you bought Google Drive space 100 GB or 1 TB on per month subscription, you may save it on original quality because you'll have a lot of space. But if you don't have any subscription from Google Drive, and you just have 15 GB free storage, then if you use high quality, you're gonna consume that pretty fast, and you end up in the storage space scarcity that cause your email to be returned, and Gmail, basically Gmail or any other thing doesn't work if you lose all the space. So for that, just choose high quality that are enough. And one another suggestion is as soon as you backup, don't delete from the device. There is one option over here, free up space. You can do that if you don't want to save the original quality photo on your drive, some physical drive. But if you want to keep your original quality photo on some physical drive, but just for the sake you want to save all of your photo in cloud and for sharing purpose. In that case, you're using Google Photos, and do not use this default free space so that you won't lose the original quality from your device. And once your device is filled up, just connect to the computer and transfer all the photos to local drive, maybe portable drive or any your laptop's hard drive, anywhere you want. But if you do this free up space, then as soon as it back up the photo to Google Drive, it deletes from the device. In that case, since you are choosing high quality instead of full quality, so high quality will be there in Google Photos on the Google Drive cloud, but you lose the original quality. So you shouldn't do free up space using the Google Photos default option. You should wait for your mobile to fill up and then transfer all of your photos to your local drive, and then it will be empty again, and once again it can be done every 2-3 months. That doesn't hurt, or even more if you have enough space on your phone. Nowadays every phone comes with 64 128, 256, 512. So if you have 64, I used to do I do on every 3-4 months transfer all the photos from mobile to device while I do the Google Photo backup as well. Another point over here, sharing, how to share your photos automatically. You don't have to manually choose your photo, choose friends photo, and you can do it by the rule. So for that, go to album section on the Google Photo app. You can do it from website on your laptop as well, photos.google.com. It's pretty much similar. You have to go to album and then create shareable album. In that case, let me go to one of the album. Okay, this is my friend, and here for the first time I choose one photo of the album, or even I don't have to do that. I go to people's, and from there I choose people's face which I want to share. For example, if I want to share someone this person a photo, then all of the photo in my device or my library, basically not the device, Google Photo library. And then I select that, and then I just click on the share album, this option. So with that, you can give some title and then hit share. After that, it will be shared automatically, and it has the option to add other person if you want. For instance, in this library, if you go to the options on the menu, three dot on the top right corner, that's a menu, and if you go there and go to option, and you'll see all the faces that are on this shared album. If you want to add some other person on the same album, you can add a face over here and say click on one of the faces you want. And one other note to this is if you took somebody's picture for the first time, Google takes a couple of days to bring that person's picture on the people section. So that may take a few days. After that, it will be available on the people section, and it won't go. Even if you delete the photo, it won't go away. Once you get the people's name, you can share to anybody you have on the Google Photo album. With this, that's pretty much it is. And then share it and give the link to them. Next time onward, when you click on picture on your device and it backed up to Google Photos, it will automatically add that to the corresponding album. This is very useful. For instance, 5-10 people are going to you and your friends are going to some vacation, 10 days vacation, and there will be 500 photos of each person. In that case, if you set up the rule with face, and then it will automatically detect and send it to the corresponding person's share album. So that's pretty much it is. One other thing you can do is you can share pets like dog or cats photo as well with this feature. But one limitation is sometimes you may want to sort some photos on the from the backward. In that case, face isn't visible, and sometimes you may want to some photos of the scene from your friend's mobile. In that case, it won't automatically add. This few scenario you can add it manually, but most of the photo people sort from the front side, so as soon as face is visible, it will automatically add to the corresponding album. It works for dog or cats, any pets and persons. One other quick tips, you can share all of your library with your partners, that means any family members. For that, you need to go to the menu on the top left corner, three horizontal bar, then setting, then choose shared libraries, and then you have to add Google account of your partners. For example, your wife, or maybe parents or any family members if you want to share. And you can revoke that by remove partner option. With that, you can get the photos automatically shared between your friends or your family members, partners. Thank you for watching my video. Please subscribe and share my channel and videos. Like my Facebook page and don't forget to click on the bell icon next to subscribe button to get notified of my future videos. If you haven't watched my previous videos, go ahead and watch. Feel free to comment if you like to know something or have feedback for me. Until next video, have a good time. Bye bye.